Italian Society of PM&R.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, dear colleagues. I have no disclosure. Conflict of interest to be closed, so we can get saves time. In the meanwhile, we could skip the first two or three slides to save time. You know that social media, the main aspect of... of social media, of the so-called social networking, is that of helping people to communicate and to share information. In the healthcare domain, this means that professionals are allowed to communicate and to share knowledge and information among themselves, and patients too, together we can share information, and professionals can share information and have contact with patients. One of the aspects is that the main group of clinicians that could help to increase the use of social media in the healthcare domain is that of the so-called connected clinician. That is, clinicians who already use this social media in the everyday life and that can bring their knowledge into the professional domain. And physical rehabilitation medicine seems to be a very suitable area for the development of social media because of its particular approach, because it's an approach which is interested also in aspects belonging to the environmental factors, not only of the biological factors of illnesses and diseases, and because of its interest in education and therapeutic education and in relation with the person served. With this in mind, we try to improve our in the framework of our society to improve the use of social media among professionals and also to increase the visibility and authoritativeness of our society in the community, thereby promoting the engagement and interaction between professionals and between professional and the community at large. So we started a program which was launched in 2015, including first of all the renewal and re-engineering of our website and the renewal of our blog, which is a virtual place in which professionals but also clients and patients and families could share information and express concerns and opinions and have a much closer interaction with the professional world, in a sense. The other aspect is that of developing a plan for integration of all of different social media, such as Facebook or Twitter, into a common framework. Also by using some common graphical features. The image, the picture we choose for our media is that of the Good Samaritan, a picture by Van Gogh, which in our opinion expresses very well the willingness to help people who is with difficulties and people suffering from, say, injuries or diseases. And the other main feature of our program is that we hired an expert, a social media expert, and who is very helpful and willing to help us in many aspects of the management of social media. One of them, which I would like to mention especially, is that of monitoring the engagement of professionals into the use of social media and the possibility to have a feedback on who is using and how the social media throughout the professional life or in other occasions. And this is this has been a very important point in making people aware of what's going on. Another part of our program is that of building this group, which we call the digital physiatrists, that is people involved in coordinating and enacting as reporters, as people who are pushing towards the use of of social in the framework of our society and in communicating with other professional bodies or community members or patients and family associations and so on. We organize the workshops around the country to explain to our colleagues which is the usefulness and also the dangers of the use of social media in our field, in our area. And it has been very useful to share information and to know how many of us are willing or are willing to participate or are able to know and to manage properly this kind of tools. Up to now, the results are just roughly expressed in numbers. That is, increased numbers of users. You may see less than 1 year, we had almost doubled the number of people willing to follow, for example, Twitter. So this is just an example. And we are going to monitor also the quality of the engagement of professionals into this kind of communication and of networking. Another result is that we felt that the role of physiatrists among other professionals is much more evident by spreading information via this social media. We launched a campaign which is almost very similar to that proposed by the American Academy about who is the physiatrist, who actually does the physiatry for helping people to improve their life and autonomy. And increase in the interaction between professionals, between physiatrists all around the country. And in conclusion, we feel that this kind of tools have a crucial role in our professional communities and in improving the visibility of our specialties in the community at large. As for the next steps, we just started with the so-called CIFER channel, that is a program of webinars. We launched it on during the World Parkinson Day last month in April, and we did some educational videos for both for professional and for community or patients and family associations. And possibly our hope is that we could increase the borders of this social network community by pulling together all the different flows of information coming from different national and international body, which could merge into a common flow of information and communication on our specialty. Thank you very much.
Very nice, and I agree that using social media as a way to connect the world of rehabilitation medicine certainly would make a lot of sense. Any questions or comments? Yes, please, sorry. You want to go to the microphone so that...
Thank you very much. That was a great presentation. How much did it cost and who funded this?
Okay. The society itself. If you want to get a rough estimate of the cost, the journalist cost is about 20,000 euros per year.
Okay, and the CIFER funded that.
Yeah.
They're a French organization, so they're going to be funding
we have a very, very large society. We are almost 2,000 members.
Yeah. So it's very impressive. We can only dream about that in Australia.
although it's interesting. I would suggest that you think, Fari, this is of interest to you. Many schools have students who are more than willing to help with projects. And we have done that for a small project that we have in amputation rehabilitation. We actually hire summer students for a very small amount of money. They were happy to do the work, get that into their curriculum. And they did a fantastic job. It was not probably as beautiful and well organized as their professional one, but it gave us a base to start from. And I think it cost us about $1,000 for a summer student. So it's not too bad. Yeah. So
I must say that if I can add something, that this same journalist is helping us in funding, finding supports from companies and so on. So we hope to have back our money because of becoming more and more visible.
Good.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. This was a wonderful session.